Good morning, everyone. My name is Stanislavinska, and we have made the research about distinction between the COVID-19 disease and influenza thanks to the wearable devices with the use of machine learning. Let me allow to start by describing the agenda of the presentation. I will start with the motivation of the research. Next, I will describe the shame of the experiments, what factors were taken into consideration, likewise the symptoms of the COVID-19 detection. I will mention also a few sentences about the cohorts, the most important part of the algorithm, the results and main outcomes of the research. Then I will summarize the results of the research and presentation. I will start with the description of the symptoms of COVID-19 detection. The development of the COVID-19 symptoms could be presented on the time arrows. The target is to recognize the disease in the early stage because it will potentially limit and decrease the ratio of contagious cases. Additionally, techniques that will be used should serve as screening tests. For this purpose, the usage of wearables seems to be justified. It could be explained by the fact that they are commonly available and relatively cheap. Moreover, there were published a few works which considered the usage of wearable likewise machine learning methodologies for COVID-19 disease analysis. You can see on the time arrow the healthy stage, the prodromal, the acute phase and the post case. And the start of the development of the disease, it actually started before 2 days of the visible symptoms. So it's really important to detect the COVID-19 disease even before the visible symptoms. So the research idea is it possible to use wearable devices to distinguish between influenza cases and COVID-19. It will protect the society and limit spreading the disease. Moreover, in some papers, the authors presented the disease stages of COVID-19. They distinguished between the early stage of the infection, stage 1, the pulmonary phase, stage 2, and the hyperinflammation phase, stage 3. The detection of the disease in the prolonged stage will have the most significant impact, since it reflects the phase in which the person is infected, but she or he feels healthy, which leads to social contacts and spreading of the disease to other people. The authors indicated that symptoms in this phase included dry cough, fever and mild contagious symptoms. The detection of the virus in this stage minimized contagiousness, preventing the development of further complication and reducing the duration of the disease. The risk factors for this disease are old age, civilization disease and hepatic dysfunction. You can see also on the left side, what are the early symptoms of the COVID-19? So there are anomalies in temperature, anomalies in resting heart rate, fever, cough, or tiredness. So based on such symptoms, it is possible to distinguish a COVID-19 disease and healthy person. In the original paper, the authors included 3 types of the dataset. The data were gathered by the wearable devices, in particular, it was various models of Fitbit smartwatches. They contained exactly COVID-19 cases, non-COVID-19 flu cases, likewise pre-COVID flu cases. The difference between non-COVID flu cases and pre-COVID flu cases was that the data were collected in different times. They were filtered to the different types of viruses. The strain A and B strain times were distinguished. The cohort tried to balance to avoid overfitting. The data were reused. The number of gathered, so-called dense data, in the original paper was 41 COVID-19 patients, 85 non-COVID flu patients and also 1,226 pre-COVID flu patients. The obtained data sets were was recomputed and the raw futures were in the respect to per 1 day. The data set was collected by wearable devices, a different kind of Fitbit. According to the original paper, there occurred difference between the COVID-19 and influenza cases in duration and intensity of the days. For the COVID-19 disease, it is visible that the disease tended to last longer than flu illnesses, and it was approximately 12 days compared with the median of the 9 days for non-COVID-19 flu and 7 days for the pre-COVID flu. So it is clearly visible that even in the duration and intensity, there are assumptions distant. So it is the assumption that it could be also created automatic system for the detection of the disease. Now I will go to the description of the variation of the experiment. The main goal of this experiment has been to avoid the accuracy of detection of COVID-19 disease. The devices were used to record values about the sleep, the number of steps and heart rate. The overall process of the conducted experiment is visible on the graph. In the first step, the futures extraction was done for each cohort. We used a time window in the range from 7 to 2 days before the reported onset of the disease by the patients. The data were disseminated to 1 per day. Next, the set of parameters was computed for the chosen window. For avoiding the course of diminutionality, the futures extraction was carried out. It is minimum redundancy, maximum relevance. The number of futures was set as 50. Subsequently, the classifier was used together with tenfold cross-validation. They were XGBoost, KNN, support vector machine, logistic regression, decision trees, and random forest. The scenarios were carried out for binary classification, multiclass classification. Here you can see in a nutshell the flow of the algorithm. Here is presented the COVID-19 disease and non-COVID flu cases. It is influenza. The data were reused from Nature's paper. The future extraction step was described in the previous slide. The future which was extracted from time series were commonly statistical measurements like mean, standard deviation, maximum, minimum, range, variance, likewise time series specific parameters, Shannon's entropy, approximate entropy, slope, skew and kurtosis. Next, the machine learning steps were evaluated. Additionally, some statistical evaluation was provided. In the tables, there are summarized the outcomes of the research. The results of the scenario with influenza in the middle of pandemic and COVID-19 disease are presented in table first. The best balanced accuracy, 73, and MCC were achieved for KNN algorithm. Nevertheless, the data were imbalanced, 57 influenza cases and 21 COVID cases. 58 of the COVID-19 cases were classified as positive sensitivity, whereas 87 of the influenza cases were classified as influenza. The high specificity for the logistic regression 61. The result of classification between COVID-19 cases and influenza cases before the main pandemic are presented in table 3. For this case, the highest balanced accuracy was obtained for SVM. Additionally, the highest number of detection influenza cases before the main pandemic, 96, was achieved for this classifier. The matrix MCCC, which taking into consideration the imbalance of the data, was the best for KNN, 69%, and similarly for SVM, 68. 77 of the COVID cases were correctly confirmed by the KNN algorithm. Moreover, we carried out the multi-class classification for recognition between COVID-19 cases, influenza before in the middle of the pandemic. For this pursuit, we evaluated the performance of the classifier with the usage of F1 score, balance accuracy and MCC, whereas F1 score is regarded as harmonic means of precision and recall. The highest results for F1 score were registered for KNN, 64%. The same situation was observed for balance accuracy, 69%, and MCC. The highest accuracy was achieved for XGBoost and SVM, 67%. On the slide, you can observe more in detail the shape of the carryout of a feature extraction step. The example of the course of the signal in time is visible in the upper left corner. The parameters which were analyzed for remainder were activity expressed in the number of steps, sleep-related parameters, and heart rate. The feature which was also like followed: mean, standard deviation, relative standard deviation, maximum, minimum, range, Shannon entropy, approximate entropy, variance, slope, skew, and kurtosis. To summarize, there is observed a difference between the COVID-19 influenza types. Based on the research, it could be stated that there are differences even between the types of influenza. The XGBoost and decision tree was 40%. This is the first trial of the automatic detection COVID-19 disease and few types of influenza. In the cure that is possible to provide multi-class classification. It has to be also highlighted the limitation of the study. To the limitation of the study belongs lack of the healthy control. Likewise, the results could be biased because they were collected in the USA. So the body mass index, a proportion of the races, could vary. Here you can see the bibliography. I would like to thank you for the Marie Curie Skłodowska Innovative Training Networks H2020. And this project has received funding from the European Union Horizon 2020.